reflection this morning, Psalm 119, chapter 119, verses 1 to 20, 1 to 128. But I read only two verses there, that we have come on the mountain of the Lord. We have come to a raised place, meaning we want to raise our hearts, our issues, the good things we do and the bad things we do. The Lord is saying, I'm your servant. Give me understanding. And the Lord also in Psalm, in Isaiah chapter 2, says, behold, there will be a raised mountain for you to worship God. This morning, our country is elevating our hearts and wants to speak to God. We know and we believe and we pray that we are fighting corruption. We are fighting tribalism. And those are the blocks of our prayer. For a moment, please, write down in your heart what you want to do. Who is it that is committing these crimes? Is it you and I who are coming here to pray? Who is practicing tribalism? Is it you and I? If it is true that we are coming here to pray that these enemies be ridden off in our country, then God will hear our prayer. There is a psalm that was sung by the choir earlier on, and that was Psalm 139. And it was sung in Kiswahili, said, Mungu unichunguze. Mungu nichunguze. Na kama kuna jambo lolote ambalo linaweza kuharibu uhusiano kati yangu na wewe, uyondoe. Permit me, Master of Ceremony, that the choir sings something and we bow as a prayer. Just one. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Today's reading will come from Colossians chapter 3, and I'll read from verse 1 to 15, and this is what it says. If then you were raised with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ is sitting at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things above, not on things on the earth. For you died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Therefore, put to death your members which are on the earth: fornication, uncleanness, passion, evil desires, covetousness, which is idolatry. Because of these things, the wrath of God is coming upon the sons of disobedience, in which you yourself once walked when you lived in them. But now you yourselves are to put off all these: anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy language out of your mouth. Do not lie to one another, since you have put off the old man with his deeds and have put on the new man, who is renewed in knowledge according to the image of him who created him. Where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcised nor uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave nor free, but Christ is all and in all. Therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, put on tender mercies, kindness, humility, meekness, long-suffering, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If anyone has a complaint against another, even as Christ forgave you, so you also must do. But above all these things, put on love, which is the bond of perfection. Verse 15, and let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also you are called in one body, and be thankful. May the Lord bless his word. Thank you.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, most merciful. I'll be reciting three verses from the Holy Quran. The recitation will be in Arabic, because the Holy Quran is in Arabic. The recitation will be from chapter 3 of the Holy Quran, and the name of the chapter is known as Ali Imran in Arabic. Ali Imran, Musa Imran, is the father of Mary. I recite. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wa'tasimu bihablillahi jami'an wa la tafarraqu وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَا حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا. كذلك يبين الله لكم آياته لعلكم تهتدون. ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر وأولئك هم المفلحون. ولا تكونوا كالذين تفرقوا واختلفوا من بعد ما جاءهم البينات وأولئك لهم عذاب عظيم. I translate the first ayah only because of time. واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا نموجه بموجة مشكمانة نيوتي كما اندوغو كامبا زم نيزمونغو. The capable of Allah, kamba ya Mwenyezi Mungu means unity. Muje pamoja, muwe pamoja kabisa. Bihablillahi, kamba ya Mwenyezi Mungu. Jamia nyote, wala tafarraku, na musitawanyike. Don't go in different ways. Wadhukuru na mukumbuke, ni'matallahi alaikum. Ni'ma za Mwenyezi Mungu juu yenu. Idh kuntum adaan, wakati mulikuwa, nyinyi katika yenu nyinyi maadui. Adui kabisa. Nyoyo zenu haiziji mamoja. Mkakosana. Idu kuntum adaan faallafa baina kulubikum. Mwenyezi Mungu nasema mimi nalete nyoyo zenu pamoja. Faasbahtum na mkakua. Bineimatihi kuwa neema za Mwenyezi Mungu. Ikhwana undugu. Wakuntum kabla Mwenyezi Mungu wakulete nyoyo zenu pamoja. Ala shafa hufratin. Mulikuwa kwa pembe ya bottleness heal with fire. That is not necessarily the physical fire, but it means the chaos. When irreconcilable hearts come together, I mean they don't come together before that. And Mwenyezi Mungu akasema, munikumbuke, mimi niko na power kulete nyoyo zenu pamoja. Kwa hivyo, this verse teaches us what we have been in 2018, and today, Mwenyezi Mungu anasema, we leave our differences, you know, and tuwe pamoja na tuendelee mbele. Thank you.
Fellow Kenyans, all equal before our God, both big and small, mighty and weak, rich and poor, without race, without division, sons and daughters of a great God. Having heard these texts from the holy books, we now wish to invite one of our religious leaders to share with us what resonates in our hearts, the invitation of the voice of God. All that today, should you listen and hear his voice, harden not your heart. We welcome now Archbishop Jackson Olesapit, the Archbishop of the Anglican Church of Kenya, to share with us some reflection. Welcome.
Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Kenya, and Mama Margaret, Your Excellency, the Deputy President, all invited worshippers today and our nation, I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Good morning. Praise the Lord. Let us pray that the Lord will open our hearts and our minds, that his word will find place in us and in our society. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we worship you this day. Another moment you have gathered us as a nation to worship you and to thank you. And today indeed we gather here to say, glory be to you, O our God, because you are exalted on high. We gather here today, Lord, to say thank you for walking us through the difficult moments, especially during the pandemic of COVID-19, And where we are at a nation, Lord, we can't miss a moment to say thank you, for you walked with us and you still walk with us. May now your word of life find place in each heart gathered here and in the hearts of Kenyans, that we may live and enjoy the life you give. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. We were gathered here in March with the invitation of His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Kenya, that the nation may gather to pray because of the threat of COVID-19 pandemic. We are gathered again here to thank God, to worship Him, and to praise His holy name, because indeed we have seen His holy hand watch on us, holding us on a daily basis. And the theme for today is glory be to God. We glorify Him because we are His children, called by His name, protected by His hand, to give Him honor and glory. We are gathered here not because we are through, but because we are happy God has been with us. And our joy is to see each one of us seated and watching throughout the nation with something to tell God thank you for. A Scottish minister by the name Alexander White was known for his uplifting prayers in the pulpit. He always found something for which to be grateful for. One Sunday morning, the weather was so gloomy, rough, and bad. I presume it must have been winter in Scotland. That morning, one of the church members wondered, what will he thank God for today? For the weather certainly is so bad that there is nothing you can say thank you God for. But when the preacher rose to the pulpit, he began with these words in his prayer, much to the surprise of the person who was thinking there is nothing to thank God for. White began praying by saying, we thank you, Thee, O God, that it is not always like this. So even in the midst of a hard moment, there is still something to thank God for, that it is not always like this. Even as Kenyans gather today watching this service, some are asking, what are we thanking God for? Our loved ones are dead because of COVID-19. They are grieving. Some are saying we are hungry, we have lost our businesses. Some are saying we don't even know how our children are going back to school. Some are at a particular point in life where they are just about to give up. And they are saying, like that worshiper, is there anything to thank God for? But the preacher still found something that is not always like this. We can also stand as Kenyans and say, yes, Lord, we are in this situation, but thank you because it will not remain like this. It is not going to remain like this. It is going to be different. Our children are going back to school and we shall celebrate when we see them sit for their national exams. Our loved ones will continue to flourish. Our farms will flourish and we shall have plenty of food. Our economy will grow and we shall look upward and say, thank you, Lord, because it will not remain like this. So, Your Excellency, you have gathered the nation today to say to Kenyans, it will not always be like this. It will be different. It shall be different. We are reflecting the words read to us, but I want to reflect those words because today is not a teaching sermon, whether is it an expository sermon I'm giving. It is a self-reflection sermon. We are gathered here to reflect on who we are indeed. And in the words of Psalms 92, this is what the psalmist say why we need to give thanks. It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praises to you, to your name, Most High, to declare your steadfast love in the morning and your faithfulness by night to the music of the lute and the lure and the harp, to the melody of the lyre. For you, O Lord, have made me glad by your works. At the works of your hands I sing for joy. We need to reflect, who are we in the presence of God today as a nation? Who are we? Who are we? Psalms 8 try to explain to us, who are we before God? Who are we? Who are we? And this is what the psalmist says in Psalms 8. Our Lord, O Lord, our sovereign, how majestic is your name. In all the earth, you have set your glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of the babes and infants, you have found a bulwark because of your foe to silence the enemy and the avenger. When I look, and I want us to pay attention to this, when I look at the heavens, the works of your fingers, the moon and the stars that you have established, what are human beings that you are so mindful about? What are they? Mortals, and you care for each one of them. I want us to reflect on these words. Who are we? What are we? Mortals. In the expanse of the universe God has created, he still finds something unique about you and me, and he cares about you. Isn't that something? Isn't that big? That God knows each and every one of us by name, and he cares about us. He cares about every situation, every moment of your life and my life. God cares about it. And you know, the psalmist was looking upward and looking at the sky, the stars and the expanse of the universe, and still ask, what is man? Who is he? Who am I that you are so, so mindful about? I think it's a moment we need to reflect as Kenyans. Who are we? Who am I? Who am I? Who are we? Sometimes we think of who are we by displaying who are we because of my position as the Archbishop, who I am as a person with some privileges. That is not how God looks at us. He looks at us differently. He looks at each soul in equal measure. Who are we? Who are we? We are gathered here today as a nation, reflecting of our journeys, and we had many, many journeys since independence, many journeys. We have journeys of great joys, but we also have journeys of great turmoils. Every 5 years so often, we fight because of elections. Every other moment, an opportunity present for competition, we rise up against each other as if we don't reason, as if we don't know who are we before God, as if we think we hold the universe and we hold the lives of other people. Today God is telling us, reflect, who are you? Who are we? What are we here for? For whose benefit have we been called to serve? Because we are all servants, starting from the head of state, our president, we are servants. We have been called to serve this great nation, each and every person, to find their meaning and joy in the things that we do on a daily basis. But far and wide, many a times, we think our lives, we control them. And by extension, we also think we control the life of other people. Let us still reflect what the prophet Micah says. Who are we in front of God? Who are we? And how can we get into that space so that God may accept us as his own creatures made after his own image and likeness. And this is what he tells us. You know, sometimes we struggle for self-reflection, for self-righteousness, and trying to give ourselves before God in many and varied ways. But this is what the Bible tells us in Micah chapter 6. What God requires of us? What does he require of you? What God does God require of me? With what shall I come before the Lord, asks Micah. And how, and bow myself before God on high? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? With the Lord, will the Lord be pleasured or pleased with 1,000 rams, with 10,000 of rivers of oil? Shall I give my firstborn for my transgression, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul? He has told you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? Listen to this. But to do justice, and to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God. Brothers and sisters, and the nation gathered today, what God requires of you and me is to do justice to all, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with our God. Is that what we do on a daily basis in our places of work? We, as clergy, do we walk humbly before God? Are we kind? Do we love? Do we protect the poor and the cause of those who need our protection? What do we do on a daily basis? What we witness every day is our self-explanation, wanting to know who you are. I found a priest one time leading his parish council and is banging the table and reminding the Christians, don't you know that I'm the vicar here? You must be quiet. That is not the way to go. It is not how powerful we are. It is not how well placed in society we are that God require of you. So as we gather to reflect as a nation, let us ask ourselves those simple questions. What does God require of you and me? Just reflect in whatever space God has given you to operate in. What does he require of you? And are we doing exactly what God requires of us? Is that what we are all about? Or we are doing some other things that God does not approve of? As a nation, God is looking upon us to be one indivisible nation under God's rule, united in love and in harmony. But are we champions of harmony? Are we champions of unity? Are we champions of oneness as a country and as a people? I want us to learn a little bit from the wild animals. I grew in a village where my daily work is to herd sheep and goats, amidst an array of different wildlife. And there are many lessons we can learn. One is from the ostrich I want to share with you. The ostrich, we have given so many names. One is that the ostrich bury their heads when it is dangerous, and I don't think that's exactly true. But let me tell you what the ostrich is about. They normally walk in pairs for their safety, and their priority number one is to safeguard their chicks and eggs. Whenever you see an ostrich seemingly like burying the head on the ground, that is the moment they are gathering their eggs together. They are putting them around themselves so that they protect them from predators. The chicks are taught not to disperse when there is an enemy. They run and cling together. And I know some of you have visited ostrich farms. When you scare chicks of an ostrich, they never disperse and run different direction. They run to stick together. Why? Because nature teaches them, if they disperse, they become easy prey for the predators. But when they stick together, the mother will always hover them with their wide wings and protect, while the father or the daddy chases the predators away. They protect each other. They surround each other with love. So when there is danger, instead of running away your different directions, they run to each other and protect together themselves. Is that what we do as Kenyans? Is that what we do as Kenyans? When there are calamities such as the pandemic and others, are we running together or we are running away from each other? And it is like we have been waiting so eagerly for the pandemic to ease so that we divide ourselves the usual way and begin the separation, either of tribalism and other forms of divisions there are in this country. God is telling us to reflect. The pandemic and any external aggression should be the reason why we need to stick together more and come to speak one language together and come and seek God together, because what God requires of you and me is for us to walk humbly before our God. May God bless us as we sit to reflect more and more, not only today, but every other day. Your Excellency, you declared these 3 days as days of prayer, yesterday, today, and tomorrow. These religious leaders have committed themselves that in our places of worship tomorrow, it's all about the nation. We so love this country. We care about it, but God cares about us more. Again, verse chapter 8 of Psalms still remind us, who are you? We are mere mortals, but God still cares about our everyday endeavors. We thank you for gathering us as a nation so that we may remind ourselves that God cares about each one of us. This is our moment of reflection. Let us continue to reflect. Who are we before God? And where are we taking this great nation? God has given us an opportunity to oversee her development agenda. Let us pray. Once more, Father, we thank you so much for your word. May your word be alive in us. May we live according to your word. Bless our nation, O God. Make us one united, indivisible, progressive country that all will enjoy in this generation and generations to come. In the name of God the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
we have reached now the moment of intercessory prayers to be offered by the religious leaders who are representing religious leaders all over our country. The first block of intercessory prayers will be to thank God. What will we thank Him for? And as we thank Him, each one of us, wherever you are, have reason to thank Him. Join your thanksgiving with the thanksgiving prayers that will be offered by our dear religious leaders here present. Commissioner Margaret Siamoya, Sheikh Mohammed Swalihu, Bishop Stanley Michuki, and Bishop Norman King-O. Let us raise our hearts in thanksgiving. Thank you, Lord, because it is not always going to be like this. Thank you, Lord, because it will be much better. And thank you, Lord, because you have strengthened our resilience. Welcome our dear religious leaders to thank Him for so many reasons that you and I, dear Kenyan, you have to raise your heart of thanksgiving. We invite all leaders to please come down to prepare.
Shall we pray? Our God and our Father, we come before you this morning. We want to thank you, Master, for your love and your care. Indeed, as we gather today as a nation, we have the reason to thank you. Dear God, we want to thank you for upholding our country, Kenya, our nation. Together in this time of COVID-19 pandemic. Oh God, we say thank you because you have seen us through. You have continued to put us together as a nation. And it is our prayer today that you continue to unite us even in time of hardship of this pandemic. You continue, my God, to bring us together, even in time of stress in this pandemic. Have mercy on us and listen to our prayers as we pray throughout the nation. We also want to thank you, my God, for all our medical people that are serving us in humility and silence. Dear God, wherever they are, I commit them into your hands, that may you kindly be with each one of them in every capacity that they are working from as health workers. Protect them from all dangers as they care for us, as they treat us, as they help us. Oh God, I commit them into your hands. And therefore, my God, continue to unite us, continue to look after us, continue to protect us. Continue to hear our prayer. God of Elijah, hear our cry and send the fire of the Holy Spirit. It is in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit we pray with our hearts full of thanksgiving. Amen.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Kwa jina la Mwenyezi Mungu, mwingi wa rehema, mwenye kurehemu. Shukrani zote ni zako ya Mwenyezi Mungu, ndiye unaofaa kushukuriwa. Tuomba msaada wako ewe Mola wetu, tuomba hifadhi yako, wala hakuna hifadhi bora kuliko yako. Tuomba uongozi mwema, ewe Mwenyezi Mungu. Tujilinde kwako kutokana na shari za nafsi zetu na machafu ya vitendo vyetu. Ewe Mwenyezi Mungu,
Tunashukuru serikali yetu tukufu pamoja na wizara ya afya na wasimamizi wote. Na tunashukuru madaktari wetu wote pamoja na wauguzi wao na wasaidizi wao na waliojitolea kwa namna yoyote ili kupigana na janga hili kubwa la corona. Janga ambalo lina hatari na limeua watu wengi duniani. Hata baadhi ya matabibu halikuwa acha bure. Tukuomba ewe Allah wapatie madaktari wetu na wauguzi wetu na wasaidizi wao roho za kutumikia wenzao na wazidishie hikma na maarifa. Tukuomba ewe Mwenyezi Mungu utuondoshee janga hili la corona lililolemeza kila upande, kwani umeileta kwa uwezo wako na tukuomba utuondoshee kwa rehema zako. Ya Allah tuhifadhi na utulinde na magonjwa mazito mazito na utuonyeshe dawa, kwani wewe ndiwe mponyaji. Ewe mponyeshaji tuondoshee maradhi na waliopata corona uwaepushie, waondoshee kwa uwezo wako ya ewe Mwenyezi Mungu. Tukuomba uilinde nchi yetu ya Kenya kutokana na kila balaa na maafa, na utuonyeshe mema kuwa ni mema na utuwezeshe kuyafuata, na utuonyeshe mabaya kuwa ni mabaya na utuwezeshe kuyaepuka. Ewe Mwenyezi Mungu tukuomba kwa kuwa shule zinafunguliwa karibu, tunakuomba ewe Mola wetu uwahifadhi watoto wetu, kwani hawajui wao lipi la kuwafana lipi la kuwadhuru, pamoja na walimu wao, na kutokana na maovu yote na haswa hii corona. Tukuomba ya Mwenyezi Mungu tukabalie maombi yetu na utusamehe dhambi zetu. Amin.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. There is no God like you in heaven above, and earth and all underneath, keeping covenant and showing steadfast love to your people, Kenya. Father, we ask your protection upon this nation that you gave us as an inheritance. We thank you, Father, because of your protection upon your president, the deputy president, the government of the day. Father, we thank you. We ask you, Lord, to continue protecting us, and especially, Father, this time of COVID-19, which has taken the lives of our people, Father, that has really made this country come to a slow country. Instead of growing faster, it has gone down. Lord, we ask you to lift our nation and, Father, revive our economy in this country. Father, we ask you to protect our students who are in the university, those who are really, my Father, in the secondary schools and primary, and also those who are really young children. Father, we need this generation at a time like this one, oh Father. Protect them, Father, from any calamity, any devastation, Father. We ask your guidance to this nation. Father, as you protect us, we ask your oneness. We ask you, Father, to pour your spirit of oneness to this nation. Father, as you protect us, we can't do without you. The armed forces cannot do without you. Police cannot do without you, Lord. We need your protection, this nation. We invoke the blood of Jesus Christ of this nation to all the corners of this country and the borders of this country, Father. We invoke the blood of Jesus. We thank you, Father, because I've done that, O Father, and we'll be walking with you, and we shall continue with you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Kwa jina la Baba na la Mwana na la Roho Mtakatifu. Mungu Mwenyezi, tunakushukuru kwa inji yetu ya Kenya. Inji nzuri. Inji yenye rasilimali nyingi na uwezo mkubwa ambao umetupatia kupitia vijana wetu. na wote wanaofanya kazi. Na kuomba wakati huu, ambapo sehemu nyingi za nchi hii zimeendelea kupata mvua na zingine zinatarajia. Tuletee mvua, kwa maana tunajua kwamba sehemu kubwa ya wananchi wa Kenya wanategemea kilimo. Ili mvua ije, tuweze kupata chakula, tuweze kupanda, tuweze kupata chakula, tuweze kuepuka njaa na aibu zinazoandamana na njaa. Mungu tubariki. Ili hizo rasilimali ambazo tumejaliwa, tuweze kuzitumia. Vijana wetu waweze kupata ajira pale, na wakulima na wengine waweze kupata mahali pa kujitegemea na kuishi maisha yenye heshima uliotuomba tuyaishi. Tunaomba hayo yote kwa njia ya Kristo Bwana wetu.
Who are we? We are precious before God. We are daughters and sons of a great God who loves and protects us. Thank you, Lord. Choir.
The choir is going to lead us in the Lord's Prayer. The words shall be superb on the screens. You can join as we pray together.
My dear sisters and brothers, there are many reasons we could have added, but now we come to the reality that is before us, the reality of the destruction that COVID has done to our society. We come to the weakness and the evil of man and the power of evil that crushes even the good seed that is planted in the heart of man. The devil who seeks to snatch that goodness in each and every human being, and instead sow hatred, discord, intolerance. And for this we have to repent and ask for forgiveness. Actions that we have done, thoughts that we have thought, omissions, and besides, as a people, that God may look upon us with mercy and heal our nation. The second block of intercessory prayers will be read, repentance and forgiveness by our leaders, religious leaders here present, Sheikh Yusuf Maki, Archbishop John Okinda, Bishop Kefa Omai, and Archbishop Frederick Wangombe. Please welcome to lead us in the intercessory prayers.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Kwa jina la Mwenyezi Mungu, mwenye kuneemesha neema ndogo ndogo na mwenye kuneemesha neema kubwa kubwa. Tunakuomba ewe Allah, Mwenyezi Mungu uliyetukuka, kwa siku hii ya leo, tunakuomba kupitia katika majina yako yote tukufu. Ewe muumba mbingu na ardhi, tunakuomba ujalie nchi yetu hii iwe yenye mafanikio, iwe ni nchi yenye furaha na vile vile inchi yenye baraka. Tunakuomba ewe Mola wetu, utuweke mbali na maradhi, maradhi ambayo ni za chuki, na utuepushe vile vile na husda za kila aina. Kwa kuwa wewe Mwenyezi Mungu huzitizami nyuso zetu, wala huna haja na ukubwa wa miili zetu, bali unaziangalia nyoyo zetu na vile vile vitendo zetu, tunakuomba utuelekeze katika matendo yaliyo mema. Ewe Mola wetu, tunakuomba utupe imani katika nyoyo zetu, zijalie ziungane nyoyo zetu sisi sote kama Wakenya. Tunakuomba uzitakase nyoyo zetu na kuziondolea uhondo na fundo zilizojaa humo. Tunakuomba utujalie upendo baina yetu na utuzidishie ihsani na huruma. Ya Rabbi, tuepushe na shari, tuepushe na fujo ya Rabbi, tuepushe na fitina na kero na vita za kikabila. Tujalie tuwe na ujirani mwema baina ya makabila zetu mbalimbali, pia baina ya watu wa matabaka mbalimbali. Tunakuomba katika mtihani na misukosuko nyingi tulizonazo za kikabila, uweze kutupatia subra, ututeremshie amani, na vile vile tuwezeshe tujivunie makabila zetu mbalimbali ambazo tuko nazo, ziwe kama dalili za sisi kujuana na kuelewana kama Wakenya. Ya Rabbi, tuondoshee wasiwasi zinazotokamana na chuki, tuondoshee wasiwasi zinazotokamana na uhasidi, na utuondoshee wasiwasi zinazotokamana na uhasama. Ewe Mwenyezi Mungu, zipokee dua zetu na toba zetu. Amen.
Dear God, we are before you this day as a nation to present our supplications to you, O Maker of heavens and earth. Almighty God, you created us all differently, but all in your image and likeness, according to your word in Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. You loved us all so dearly that you sent your beloved Son, Christ Jesus, to die for all of us. You did this without any discrimination whatsoever. We thank you for the great diversity in our culture, our tribe, political affiliations, opinions, and preferences that make up the citizens of this beautiful country called Kenya. Lord, we pray that you may give us the spirit of embrace so that we can embrace one another with love that goes beyond all indifferences. Lord, I pray that our hearts will become of kindness to one another while forbearing one another, as your word commands in the book of Ephesians chapter 2. Be completely humbled and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. Dear God, we pray that your peace that surpasses all understanding may be with us, so that we may be able to live and coexist in harmony. Abba Father, we pray that you will knit us in unity as a nation, from the eldest to the youngest of this country. We come against the spirit of violence, bloodshed, destructions in the name of Jesus. We pray that you may guide each one of us to be ambassadors of peace. As your word says clearly in the book of Matthew, chapter number 5, verse 9. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the sons of God. Father, we pray that there be no violence in this country, that the tribes and communities which you beautifully made shall rise against one another again. Oh God, we pray. We invite your presence to be with us and guide us in our families. The spirit of gender-based violence, This we pray that may not thrive in our homes. Cause us, God, to grasp and utilize other forms of conflict resolutions. And most importantly, I pray that you may give us the spirit to forgive one another, as you commanded in your word, when you said clearly, and when you stand before praying, forgive. If you have aught against any, that your Father also in heaven may forgive your purposes. Mark chapter 11 verse 25 says, Almighty Father, we ask that you give peace to the brokenhearted and heal the hearts of victims and families that have been vastly affected in the past in one way or another by violence. As we pray for tolerance among the citizens of this great country, so God, we commit all our leaders across all sectors in government, the opinion leaders, the judiciary, and all houses of legislation, the Senate, the Parliament, and county assemblies. Oh God, we pray that these leaders are put here for you, God, to serve your will. Oh God, knit them together as one, and may they use their synergy for the betterment of this beloved nation. As the key vision bearers, we commit all political leaders in your hands and pray for peace amongst them. We rise against the spirit of political violence in gatherings of rallies or meetings. We pray that you may cause us to learn from our past shortcomings, never again to shed blood or lose life for political reasons. Oh God, in the same manner we pray that God, the Spirit of God, will bring understanding across the leaders and stakeholders in the private sector, in the various professional unions. Father, we bless you, and we bless you indeed. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We continue in repentance. The Bible says in the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 7, and verse number 14, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves, turn away from the wicked way, seek my face and pray, I will hear from heaven, forgive their sins, and heal their land. Shall we come before God in prayer? Loving Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, as we continue waiting upon you, Father God, we come with hearts of repentance. We ask you, Lord, to forgive us in line with your word. For your word says, if your people that are called by your name shall humble themselves, turn away from their wicked ways, seek your face and pray, you will hear from heaven and you'll forgive their sins and heal their land. Kenya is our land. And as your people, my Father, and as the subjects of this nation, we confess that we have sinned against you. Father God, we repent of the sin of greediness, being selfish, oh God, excessive desire for more than what we have at the expense of those who are poor. Today and right now, Father, we repent and we ask you to forgive us. Forgive us, oh God, as a nation. Forgive us as your people, oh God, in line with your word, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Lord, your word says in the book of Proverbs, chapter 14, and verse number 34, righteousness exalts a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. We have reproached you, O God. We have sinned against you, O God. Father God, we have practiced selfishness in this country, and we come before thee with humility, O God, asking that you may forgive us, O God. Forgive us for having no regard for others, O God. Father God, we pray that you may set us free as a nation. Lord God, your word says, if we confess our sins, you are just and faithful to forgive us, O God, and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Oh God, may you forgive us of the sin of corruption in this country. In the name of Jesus Christ, we bow before you. We plead for mercy, oh God. In wrath, remember mercy. In wrath, remember mercy. In wrath, remember mercy. Lord, we join together as a nation, O God, from border to border, pleading for mercy. In wrath, remember mercy. Forgive us, O God, of this sin of corruption. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Let's continue prayers. Our Heavenly Father, we worship you because of who you are. You are independent of all creation and have in you and of yourself. You are omniscient, omnipotent, and omnipresent. We glorify your name. We confess our sins, the sins we have sinned as a family, the sin we have sinned as a church and as a nation, which we have committed either knowingly or unknowingly. And because you are rich in mercy, please forgive us so that you may hear our prayer as a nation. Create in us hearts of forgiveness so that we see each other as brothers and sisters. We want to thank you, God, for this new day. Thank you for giving us life and giving us strength to keep going. Thank you for the president of this country, His Excellency Uhuru Kenyatta, and his deputy and the whole government. Thank you for the church and all Kenyans, wherever they are. We can't thank you enough for the things you have done to us as a country. Heavenly Father and our dear God, you guide us in everything, in wisdom, mercy, and love. Accept these prayers we offer for you as a nation. Watch over every Kenyan and please heal our country. And especially at this time when COVID 19 pandemic has taken our nation and the nations around the world, causing turmoil and fear. We trust you alone to save us from it. And we're encouraged by your holy book that whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of Almighty, and you will save them. Dear Heavenly Father, please be our refuge of this country and protect it from all evil and diseases. Heavenly Father, we pray for the sick in the hospital and at homes so that you may strengthen your able hand of healing and deliver them from all kinds of diseases that they may be suffering from. Bless our children and protect them from the evil one as they resume classes. We pray that God, you may watch over them and guide them. Lord, we pray for the marginalized people and aged ones in the society so that you may always provide them and meet at their points of need. May your grace be sufficient to them and may you walk with them. God, feel merciful for us and protect them from all evil. Heavenly Father, we have gathered here as a nation to offer your prayers, and because you have given us grace to bring our prayers to you, and you promise that where two or three gathers and agree together in your name, will grant their request. Fulfill, Lord, our desires and prayers, as may be passed. It may be best for through Jesus Christ, the Lord, who lives and reigns with you and Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, our leaders, for leading us in that prayer session. God has promised that any person who comes to him in repentance, he will hear. That is one prayer you don't have to wonder whether God has heard or not. The prayer of repentance is always heard if it is done sincerely. God is healing our land. We want to take this time to just hear him from our music team. And then we are going to come back and hear readings from the Holy Scriptures, first from our Hindu community, read to us by Madam Sujata, and then we'll have from the Holy Bible, read to us by Archbishop Stephen Marete. So once the choir has sung, please, those two, if you could come and do the reading. Why don't I ask us to stand and sing with the choir? We have been seated for a while.
Namaste. Namaste to all. Hope and peace prayers from Adharvana Veda scriptures. Om Namaste Astu Bhagavan Vishveshwaraya Mahadevaya Trayambakaya Tripurantakaya Trikagnikalaya Kalagni Rudraya Nilakhantaya Mruchumjayaya Sarveshwaraya Sadashivaya Sriman Mahadevaya Namaha. Offer my salutations to Lord Shiva, who is the Lord of the universe, who is the great God, who has three eyes, who is the annihilator of Tripura, the city of demon. Tripura also represents our ego, who is the master of sacrificial fire of three kinds, who is Rudra, who consumes everything as the fire of Kala Agni at the time of destruction. One whose throat is blue, who is the conqueror of death, who is the lord of all, who is always auspicious. Salutations to Rudra, who is the celebrated and great God. Let your play of drinking water, the common, and your food be together as I yoke you to a common yoke. Worship Agni, all of you together, just as the spokes are attached to the navel of the chariot from all around. O mankind, I enjoin on all of you to be mutually helping one another, to be united in your mind, and to have common ideal of life for benefiting one another. Like the enlightened persons who ever take care of immortal principle, may the friendly feelings amongst you increase morning and evening. These five senses with the mind as the sixth, which abide in my heart, are made sharp by means of prayer, by which all the awful works are done. May we attain peace by them. May the atmosphere give us peace and safety, and may both this heaven and earth be secure for us. May we be free from danger from west and east. And may there be no fear from north and south. May we be fearless of our friends and even of those who are unfriendly to us. May we never fall in dread of those whom we know and even those we don't know. May we remain free from any apprehension by night and in the daytime, and may all the quarters be friendly to us. Loka samasta sukino bhavantu. May the whole world be at peace. Ashanti. Mungawa bariki, ashanti sana, amani, amani, amani.
Praise God. I'm reading from the book of James, chapter 1, verse 16 to 18. Do not get deceived, my dear brothers. Every good gift and every perfect present comes from heaven. It comes down from God, the creator of the heavenly light, who does not change or cause darkness by turning. By his own will, he brought us into being through the word of truth, so that we should have first praise among all his creatures. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. At this point, we want to enter again into another session of intercession prayers, this time calling upon God to bring healing and restoration upon our country. We'll be asking our religious leaders who are here with us to lead us in this time of prayer, Bishop David Kamau, Bishop Samuel Deongo, Bishop Catherine Mutua, Bishop Joshua Koyo, and Sheikh Abdallah Ateka. Please come and lead us in this prayer. Very important, because we need God to heal us from the COVID-19, heal and restore us from corruption, and heal our economy and bring job creation and regenerate the fruitfulness of our land. Bishops, come.
Tuombe. E Mungu Mwenyezi na Muumba, tunajua unatupenda. Unampenda binadamu. Hiyo ndio maana yake. Baada ya kuumba kila kitu, ulimuumba akiwa na mfano na uso wako. Ulitaka mtu akujue, akupende na akutumikie. Baada ya binadamu kupotea, ulimrudisha kwako kwa njia ya mwanao mpenzi Yesu Kristo. Kwa maisha yake, kwa mahubiri yake, kwa uponya na hasa kwa kifo na ufufuko, alitupatia uzima wa milele. Na sasa, Mungu Mwenyezi, tunajua ni wewe ulikuwapo, ni wewe upo, na ni wewe utakuwapo. Tunakuomba kazi Yesu Kristo alifanya ya uponyaji, alikuwa akiyafanya, aendelee kuifanya kati yetu. Uwaponye wote wana COVID-19, uwatulize na utulize familia zao, ili wazidi kutimiza lengo la maisha yao, hasa kukujua, kukupenda na kutumikia. Na tunaomba hayo kwa njia ya Kristo Bwana wetu. Kwa jina la Baba, na la Mwana, na la Roho Mtakatifu.
Tuendelee kwa maombi. Mungu Baba, Mwana na Roho Mtakatifu, kama kanisa na madhehebu yote hapa nchini Kenya, tukiongozwa na rais wetu His Excellency Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta, tunaomba katika jina la Yesu Kristo usaidie viongozi wetu na kila mmoja wetu katika jamii ya Kenya, ili sote tukaweze kuimarisha ushumi wetu wa nchi yetu. Utuokoe, tupone, Mungu mwema, kutokana na anasa, siasa ya kikabila, ufisadi, vita vya jamii na mambo mengine kama hayo ambayo Mungu wetu tumeona yakirudisha nchi yetu ya Kenya nyuma. Tumekusanya hapa katika njia ya utulivu, njia ya kuomba msamaha na njia ya tomba ya ukweli kutoka kwa mioyo yetu, ili Bwana ukaweze kutusikia na ukaweze kuponya nchi yetu ya Kenya. Pia Bwana tunaomba siku ya leo ili ukawezeshe serikali yetu ya Kenya iweze kutengeneza nafasi za ajira, ili vijana na wote ambao wanaohitimu kutoka vyuo vikuu wapate nafasi ya kusaidika, ili waweze kutusaidia sisi wote tushikane mikono pamoja kama jamii moja ya Kenya, tuweze kuimarisha nchi yetu na pia tuweze kuimarisha uchumi wa nchi yetu tukufu ya Kenya. Katika jina la Mungu Baba, Mwana na Roho Mtakatifu tumeomba na hata kuamini.
Let's continue praying. Heavenly Father, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, mighty Savior, the everlasting King and King of all the glory, we are humbled here this morning with one purpose, to come and seek your face. How we acknowledge your preeminence. We acknowledge your eminence, O God. We acknowledge your sovereignty. Lord, we acknowledge your powers. We are here because we want to commit our leaders unto your hands. And especially when we talk of corruption, something that has been taught by our president. Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, the Bible says that when the nation is ruled by the righteous, the nation rejoices. But when the wicked rules the earth or the nation, O God, the people mourns. How we pray in the mighty name of Jesus, the power of God will come upon this nation. We now prevent the corrupt leaders in getting into power in the mighty name of Jesus. We want to declare our nation. We want to declare the Lord, we shall be led by people who fear you in the mighty name of Jesus. We worship you, Father. We give you all the glory. How we call heaven. Heaven, we are calling upon you. May you open the doors. May you open the windows. The Lord Jesus, you may continue to rule our nation. How we commit our leaders unto your able hands. Father, we pray greed and even corruption will be a thing of the past. For we believe the Lord Jesus Christ, because of your intervention, you'll be able to get into the minds and even to the hands of our leaders so that they can be able to lead us. We pray that, Lord, give us leaders. Don't give us rulers. We want people who lead this nation. We thank you. We praise you. We magnify your holy name. Lord, we are looking forward
to see you walking and even working with us. And especially this time when we need peace and justice. We now commit even the president of the High Court. In the mighty name of Jesus, may he become the mouthpiece of justice in those corridors of law. In the mighty name of Jesus, how we embrace peace and power. We thank you, we praise you. In Jesus' name, Lord, we pray. Amen.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Kwa jina la Mwenyezi Mungu, Mwingi wa Rehema na Mwenye Kurehemu. Sifa zote njema ni zake Mwenyezi Mungu, Mola wa viumbe vyote. Mwingi wa Rehema, Mwenye Kurehemu, Mwenye kumiliki siku ya malipo. Wewe tu tunakuabudu na wewe tu tunakuomba msaada. Tuongoze katika njia iliyonyooka, njia ya wale walioneemeshwa. Wala sio njia wala waliopotea wala waliokasirikiwa. Ya Allah, tunakuomba kwa dhati yako tukufu, ubariki nchi yetu ya Kenya. Tunakuomba pia kwa dhati yako tukufu, ubariki kiongozi wa nchi yetu ya Kenya, Mheshimiwa Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. Bariki baraza lake la mawaziri na viongozi wote ambao wanamsaidia kuendesha nchi yetu ya Kenya. Ya Allah, tunakuomba kwa dhati yako tukufu, tuondoshe haya maradhi ambayo yalikuja corona. Uinue uchumi wetu ambao umeharibika kwa ajili ya maradhi ya corona. Utupe uwiano na maelewano na mapendano kwa Kenya wote kwa ujumla, waishi kwa amani. Tunaomba haya Mola wetu mtukufu, mwanzo usiokuwa na chanzo na mwisho usiokuwa na kikomo, rehma na amani zimshukie Nabii Muhammad na mtume wote waliotangulia. Amin, Rabbi, amin. Walhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen.
We are coming before God once again. Heavenly Father, King of Glory, a mighty one of heaven, God, we come before you as children going to their father. And God, in faith, we are assured you will give us the desire of our heart, the desire of this country, God. Father, we are bringing before you to heal this country and restore this country. And in healing this country, God, remove from us, from the Mideast, from the hearts of Kenyans, from the hearts of the leadership of Kenyans, things that divide us, and give us things that unite us as a country, as a nation, led by one leadership. God, help us to demonstrate that we are one. God, on this I pray that you remove from us divisiveness. Divisiveness is wicked. God, remove from us nepotism. Nepotism is wickedness. God, remove from us tribalism. Tribalism is wickedness. God, remove from us parochialism. Parochialism is wickedness. Father, you are described, you are called a wonderful counselor. God, we pray that counsel the people of Kenya to remove all these things that divide us. God, I pray that you counsel the leadership of Kenya down to the devolved system to remove this wickedness, so this country remain a united country. Father, you are described as the Prince of Peace. Father, when you remove this wickedness, the country will remain in peace. God, thank you. God, I pray this in the mighty name, the name above all names, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Bishop, and all the leaders who have led us this far. The choir comes to sing and lead us in singing one of the very powerful hymns, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine. It's one of the most powerful confessions that one can make. And I would want to ask you again if you can rise. The words will be the screen, and we can sing together as we make this powerful confession. You may be seated. We go into that session as we continue with prayers. This time we want to pray for our aspirations, those things that we desire would happen in this nation. And to lead us in this session of prayers is our leaders, Kamal Gupta, Reverend Joseph Mutie, Sheikh Ali Samoja, and Bishop Robert Langat. I would like to ask them to come and lead us in this prayer as we bring our desires to God.
Namaste. I, on behalf of entire Hindu community, wishes to Almighty God to extend peace and courage to my fellow citizens, so together we win this fight against COVID-19. I pray Gayatri Mantra is a universal prayer for resilience and tolerance. Om Bhur Bhuvah Swah Tat Savitur Vareniyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Nah Prachodayat. May the Almighty God illuminate our intellect to lead us along the rigorous path. Our hearts are filled with darkness, so please make this darkness distant from us and promote illumination within us. Mahamrityunjay mantra is a life-saving mantra. Om Triambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukmiva Bandhanan Mrityor Mokshi Yamamratat. Hey Lord Shiva, please restore mental, physical and emotional health and happiness and bring peace to our mind. O Supreme God, give us the power to feel you, and by this, we feel happy, satisfied, and peace. Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina mantra is for patience and courage. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kashchit Dukh Bhav Bhavet. May all be prosperous and happy. May all be free from illness. may all see what is spiritually uplifting. May no one suffer in any ways. Finally, World Hindu Peace Prayer says, Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. This mantra stands for peace for all. We pray to Lord that there will be peace everywhere. Sky, earth, water, herb, tree, everything and everyone will be in complete harmony. All will be prosperous and happy. All will be free from illness. All will be uplifting spiritually and enjoy tranquility. Om Amani 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 to all my fellow citizens and our great leadership of my great country, Kenya. Thanks a lot.
Natuombe kwa jina la Baba na la Mwana na la Roho Mtakatifu. Mtakatifu Mungu, Mtakatifu Mwenyezi, Mtakatifu uishie milele. Unaye watazama walio wanyonge na walio nyenyekea mbele zako kwa macho ya huruma. Tazama, tujongea mbele zako asubuhi ya leo, siku hii ya leo na wakati huu, tukiomba kwako Mungu ukaweze kutupa amani na umoja na uwiano. Mioyo yetu yatazamia kwamba utaondoa chuki na uhasama ambao unaishi katikati yetu. Baba, utaweza kutupa nafasi tuweze kuishi kama ndugu na dada, kama ambao waliozaliwa katika familia moja na nyumba moja ya Kenya. Mungu wetu, tuomba utulinde na angalie matazamio na matarajio ya mioyo yetu Bwana, kulingana na mapenzi yako. Tujalie neema zako, na maombi yetu haya ya siku ya leo yakaweze kuponya inji yetu ya Kenya, tukaweze kuendelea kwa uwiano, na tukaweze kukataa mambo ambayo yataweza kutufanya tutengane. Roho wako Mtakatifu akaweze kuingia katika mioyo yetu na kutujaza na kicho chako. Mungu wetu, twakualika ukaweze kuishi katika inji yetu ya Kenya na uangaze njia zetu. Twaomba tukijua umetusikia, kwa jina la Baba na la Mwana na la Roho Mtakatifu. Amen.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نانزا kwa jina lake Mwenyezi Mungu mwingi wa huruma na rahma, sifa zote njema ni zako ewe Mola wetu, muumba wa viumbe vyote vilivyomo angani na ardhini. Utukufu ni wako Bwana wa kila kitu, ewe mlezi mkerimu. Tukushukuru kwa kila neema kubwa ama ndogo, kwa amani na usalama. Tukushukuru na tukuhimidi Mola wetu katika hali zote, katika furaha na huzuni, katika afya na maradhi, katika ufukara na utajiri, katika wema na madhara. Rahma zako na amani ziwe juu ya waja wako wateule. Twaja kwako Mola wetu tukikiri udhaifu wetu na unyonge wa hali zetu, baada ya nyingi dhambi zetu na uchache wa shukurani. Tusimama mbele zako tukinyenyekea, tukijua kwamba bila ya huruma yako sisi ni wenye kuangamia. Tukuomba Mola wetu, kwa kuwa wewe ndiye uliyetuamuru tukuombe na kisha ukatuahidi kutujibu, uduuni astajib lakum. E Mola wetu, e Bwana wetu, e Mungu wetu, tukulilia tukulalamikia hali ya watoto wetu, vijana wetu, viumbe vyako dhaifu wenye kuhitaji rahma zako. Tuomba msaada wako wanyoshie njia, wahifadhi, wakinge kutokana na shari na ushawishi wa ibilisi na wafasi wake. Wafungue akili zao waweze kupata maarifa na ujuzi, wakunjulie vifua vyao wapate kutambua na kukuabudu. nyoyo zao zitie mwangaza, zinawiri kwa elimu. Mola wajalie wasomi wetu wawe na mapenzi na bidii ya kuchuma elimu na maarifa. Mola wetu zijalie shule zetu ziwe na amani na utulivu, na ziwe jimbuko la hikma na maarifa. Mola wetu wajalie walimu wetu na walezi wetu katika shule zetu, na viongozi wa taasisi za elimu zetu wawe na ari na moyo kujifanya kazi ya mitume wako, wawalee vijana kwa bidii na kujitolea kwa ajili yako, ili umma wetu upate kuimarika na kumakinika katika amri zako, na ili wema uene. Mola wetu wajalie walimu wetu wawe ni mifano bora kwa watoto wetu na vijana wetu, ili haki iwe na nguvu na ubatili uangamize kabisa. Mola wetu tufanyie wepesi katika hali hii ya corona ambayo imetulemea, utufungulie milango za faraja, tunusurike na shari ya maradhi. Shule zetu, wanafunzi wetu na walimu na walezi, uepushe na magonjwa na shari zote, wajalie afya na uaminie rahma zako na baraka zako. Wafanyie wepesi yote yenye uzito, wafungulie milango za riziki ili wapate kutulia. Mola wetu mjalie rais wetu na viongozi wetu wote afya na nguvu, wapate kutumikia na kuwatumikia waja wako katika kheri na radhi zako. Mola wetu wajalie wote busara na hikma. Mola wetu tuhifadhie taifa letu na nchi yetu, utujalie kupendana na kuhurumiana. Rabbana aslih lana sha'nana wa hayyi lana min amrina rushda innaka ala kulli shay'in qadir wa sallallahu ala muhammadin wa alihi at-tahirin.
Let us pray together. Our gracious and most loving Heavenly Father, from whom all the families on the face of the earth derive their name, the family of the nation of Kenya as well get their name from you. We want to thank you, Lord, that this nation has been placed on this part of East Africa with a sense of purpose, a vision, and a mission. And your word tells us that righteousness exalts a nation. And you have also told your prophet Joel that after all these locusts have devastated the earth, you will restore that which was eaten by the locusts. And you told your servant that your people shall never be put to shame again. You told your prophet that in the end, our sons and daughters shall prophesy. In the end, our sons and daughters, our old men will dream dreams, and our young men will see visions. Behold, O Father, this is a nation of dreams and aspirations. Behold, O Father, we pray that everything that has not been dug out of the ground of this nation to bring prosperity, that you will bless, so that will bring a prosperity to our land. Everything of our mind, every artist, every social thing, every political aspiration, every economic aspiration of our nation, and more importantly, Jehovah God, every spiritual aspiration of our nation, that you shall prosper and bless our people together. And now, Lord, as we pray for the prosperity of the land, we know that from the dreams of our fathers who founded our nation, that poverty and disease and ignorance shall be rid of this land, is still here with us. And so we combine our faith today that, Father, you will remember the poor, that you will help us, those of us who have, to share with them that don't have. Father, those who feel neglected, those who feel marginalized, we pray, our Father, that we will come together as sons from small and big families, as daughters from small and big families, that we will unite our hearts and we will make our nation prosper, so that there will be joy on the plains of Mandera and all the way to the islands of Lake Victoria, that from the mountains of Mount Kenya all through the plains of Rift Valley, Jehovah prosperity will be in this land. And so we pray for every talent, we pray for every dream, we pray for every vision that you have for our nation. As we commit our leadership who are leading us in this dream and visioning and dreaming how a great country can be raised of great men and women from here, Lord. Lead our president together with his entire team as he leads us in this vision and aspirations and the dreams of our nation. May everything that has been put in our governing documents, right from the Constitution, our national anthem, every aspiration be blessed of you, God. We pray, trusting and believing in Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Bishop Langat, and all those who have read us in this block of prayers for aspirations, dreams, what God wants to use us to achieve greatness in our nation, greatness in our families, greatness in our souls and lives, and become a witness of his glory. At this moment, we invite the choir, and following a good tradition that has been set by my co-master of ceremonies, I invite you all to stand and sing together with the choir. You. Please take your seats. May our souls, may our hearts sing to the Lord, for he's great and wonderful, but wants us to share his wonder and greatness. But we, poor humans, poor creatures, often impede that wonderful work of creation, of sanctification, of being a part of God's splendor and glory. All that we Kenyans may listen and let him carry out his work in our hearts. We now come to the fifth block of our intercessory prayers. Tutaombea viongozi wa kila aina na tabaka. Tutaombea viongozi wetu wa nchi yetu ya Kenya, viongozi wa familia, viongozi katika makaunti. Tutaombea familia zetu ambazo twajua ndio makao ya Mwenyezi Mungu. Twasema ni kanisa ndogo kwetu. Humo ndipo Mungu anatenda makuu. Hupo ndipo anaunda utakatifu na sifa za ubinadamu. Basi tuombe atupe hekima. Tuombe atupe roho iliyofunguka. Neema zake zikamilike katika maisha yetu, baadaye maisha ya nchi yetu na kila aina ya vikundi. Katika sala hizi tutaongozwa na viongozi wetu wa makanisa na madhehebu na dini mbalimbali ambazo watatuongoza, wataleta sala na maombi kwa niaba yetu sisi. Canon Reverend Chris Kinyanjui, Bishop Joseph Ntombura, Bishop Samuel Jiriri, naye Sheikh Hassan Olenado. Na waomba kwa unyenyekevu waweze kuja na kutoa sala zetu ili Mungu aweze kutubadili tuwe viumbe vyake vya kumpa sifa na utukufu, na nchi yetu iwe kweli ni nchi yake ambaye anatukuzwa. Karibuni.
We continue to pray for our religious leaders and their prophetic messages, and especially at this time and it appears to be dormant. Let us pray. Father, we come to you in the name of Jesus, with the help of the Holy Spirit, and by your grace, we join with the heavenly host, making a joyful noise to you and serving you with gladness. We come before your presence with singing. We particularly thank you for our religious leaders in this country, and especially for the role they play in providing prophetic voices. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray and confess that the Spirit of God, the Spirit of wisdom, reason, and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of prophetic utterance, shall rest upon our religious leaders. We pray that your Spirit rests upon them. You make them a quick understanding, because you, Lord, have anointed and qualified them to have prophetic voice to the meek, to the poor, hopeless, to the wealthy, the powerful, and the afflicted. You sent them to bind up and heal the broken, to proclaim liberty to the physical and spiritual captives, and to open the prison and the eyes to those who are bound. As a nation, it seems we have all sinned and come short of glory of God. The church, the mosque, and other places of worship as a body cannot escape blame in this whole enterprise of abomination. It is time to do away with the injustice, corruption, political intolerance, greed, intimidation, and absence of an abuse of office. We believe that together, if we are sincere and show gratitude enough to him who deserves it, he will open the heavens and hear our prayers. Because of current filthy political and moral environment, we badly need religious leaders who are uttering prophetic messages that will lead us to repentance. Repentance is what will purify our nation so that our land and the people will be healed. So our dear God, we need to pray that you divinely touch our religious leaders so that they will play their part, expecting them, Father, to have the rekindled message of prophecy so that our land will be healed. We thank you, Father, because of giving us more Jeremiahs, we believe, more Samuels, more Daniels, and more Amoses, so that, Father, because of our partnering with you through these prophets, we'll be able to command the impossible. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, our King, who appoints men and women as leaders of organizations and governments, communities and families, we beseech you, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We pray that you guide our leaders towards paths of righteousness and selflessness, justice and fairness. Wonderful Counselor, we lift our hearts to you, and we pray that you give knowledge and wisdom to our leaders. We pray that as they make decisions and judgments, sometimes that are difficult, we pray that, Lord, they will be pleasing to you and responsive to the needs of our people. King of kings and Lord of lords, you are the one that has called us as leaders. And Lord, together, we pray that you teach us to serve one another. You taught us that, Lord, the one who is greatest
should serve the one who is the least of us. And you took a child as an example. Lord, teach us, Lord, all of us as leaders, to serve one another. Teach us, Lord, how to wash each other's feet. Lord, we pray that Prince of Peace, you will empower our hearts and acknowledge you as our God and our Lord. We pray that you help our leaders to acknowledge that leadership is a trust, a public trust, and a trust from you, so that we exercise it in a manner that honors God and respects the people, promotes the honor of our beloved nation, and edifies and builds the moral fiber of our society. We pray, O Lord, as situations become storms, that, Lord, the paralyzing fear and shame that sometimes afflict us as leaders shall be replaced by faith and courage, so that we shall all rise up and resolve the problems that affect our people. Above all, Lord, we pray that you guide our leaders to fear you, to fear God, and to embrace the responsibility to serve people rather than Lord over them. How we pray, O Lord, that may your kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. Establish your kingdom in this Republic of Kenya. Establish your kingdom in our hearts. Uphold it, Lord, with justice and righteousness from this time henceforth. May our leaders speak with one voice. We ask this in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Tuombe kwa sababu ya jamii zetu kwa jina la Yesu. Mungu mwema, baba yetu wa binguni, kwa jina la Yesu, tuwaja mbele zako mchana wa leo. Asanti mfalme wetu kwa sababu ya jamii zetu zote katika nchi yetu ya Kenya. Mungu baba, ninawakabidhi mkononi mwako, wazee, wamama, vijana, wasichana, wadogo kwa wakubwa katika jina la Yesu. Asanti mfalme mwema kwa sababu unapenda nchi hii yetu ya Kenya. Kama vile neno lako linavyosema ya kwamba Daudi akasema nalikuwa mdogo na sasa nimezeeka na sijaona mtu ambaye ni mcha Mungu ukiwa wewe Bwana umemwachilia. Asanti kwa sababu hautatuacha ewe mfalme, hautaacha jamii zetu katika jina la Yesu. Tazama uone Bwana, kuna wengine ambao wanalia kwa sababu watoto wetu wengine wameingia katika mihadarati, dawa za kulevya. Watoto wengine wetu wamekuwa wakaidi. Na ewe mfalme, katika jina la Yesu, ninaomba ukatusaidie sisi kama wazazi, ili tukaweze kuwalea watoto wetu kwa maadili mazuri, wasija wakaingia kwenye elimu ambayo imepotoka na mafundisho mabaya ya kishetani. Asanti Bwana kwa sababu utaendelea kutushikilia na kutupa uwezo wa kuwalea watoto wetu katika kicho na mafundisho yako. Na njia ambayo tutalea watoto wetu hawatatoka katika hiyo njia hata watakapokuwa watu wakubwa. Baba Mungu, ninaombea jamii zetu kwa wale ambao wako na huzuni, naomba ukawafariji wakati kama huu. Kuna wengine ambao wako na magonjwa, ukawaponye Bwana. Kuna wengine wako na taabu na shida na umaskini, ukawakumbuke wakati huu. Kuna wengine doa zao zimezambaratika, ninaomba Bwana, kwa sababu wewe ni Mungu wa urejesho, ukakumbuke hizo doa katika jina la Yesu. Asanti Bwana kwa sababu neno lako linasema mambo yaliyo mema, mambo yenye sifa njema, mambo ambayo yanastahili tukayatende hayo. Na unasema ya kwamba neema yako ambayo imepita fahamu zote za wanadamu itatuhifadhi mioyo yetu na nia zetu katika Kristo Yesu. Asanti Bwana kwa sababu utaendelea kutubariki na kutushikilia, na jamii zetu zitasimama tukikumbuka baba wetu wa taifa ambaye ndiye baba wetu, rais wetu. Kuna pia viongozi wetu walio chini yake, the deputy president, viongozi walio chini ya mamlaka, wote ni wazazi, pia na wakumbuka mbele zako. Asanti kwa sababu inchi hii yetu ya Kenya, wazazi wetu, utawashikilia, watoto wetu, kuendelea na njia zako, na hizo njia hawatazitoka hata watakapoendelea na haya maisha yasiyodumu. Utubariki na ubariki jamii zote kwa Kristo Yesu, tumeomba na hata tumeamini. Amen.
Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. I pray for His Excellency the President, his deputy, the cabinet, and leadership of all levels of the national government, and for government and county governments and all levels of leadership in the country. Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. Ya Allah, bestow on the leadership of this great nation to lead us, your servants, with wisdom, and to guide us, your servants, with humility, Ya Rab. Ya Rab, inspire our leaders to always seek righteousness and to be benevolent to your creation. Ya Allah, instill in them fear of engaging in corruption in your land. Ya Allah, strengthen them, our leaders, to be truthful and just to your creation, for peace, love, and harmony to prevail. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد والحمد لله رب العالمين آمين يا رب العالمين آمين.
Thank you, our leaders. We'll invite the choir to lead us in one song. This time, to break from tradition, I would allow us to just sit as the choir sings. Powerful prayer right there. As one of our leaders was leading us in prayer, he referred to a text of scripture that is found in the book of Joel. And I felt in my spirit that God is speaking this word to us as Kenyans today. As we come to the close of this prayer, let me read for you these words, which I believe are from the heart of God to us as a nation. They are found in Joel chapter 2, verse number 23, and I'll read to verse number 27. This is what it says. Be glad, all you people. Rejoice in the Lord your God, for he has given you the autumn rains in righteousness. He sends you abundant showers, both autumn and spring rains as before. The threshing floors will be filled with grain. The vats will overflow with new wine and oil. I will repay you for the years that the locusts have eaten. The great locust, the young locust, other locusts, and the locust swarms, my great army that I sent among you. You will have plenty to eat until you are full. Isn't that a good word at lunchtime? And you will praise the name of the Lord your God, who has worked wonders for you. Never again will my people be ashamed. Then you will know that I am God in Kenya, that I am the Lord your God, and there is no other. And never again will my people be ashamed. Thus says the Lord. I believe God is doing a new thing in this country. Your Excellency, every time in Scripture that a leader of a nation has turned the face of his people towards heaven, God comes down. God comes down. And because out of your own volition, some people may think this was our initiative. It was not. It is the president who asked us, can we have prayers on the 10th of October? Ours was to say, yes, sir. And here we are. I believe God is going to do something as a result of this call. The time you have spent under this tent is not in vain. That which the locusts, and in our case is actual locusts, that actually came and ate our land. The locust of COVID, the locust of corruption, the locust of tribalism, the locust of all kinds, are all going to be restored, the things that they ate, because our God has spoken. Our industries are going to rise up. And these are not idle words. You know, some people think we religious leaders, we just talk. Open your eyes and begin to see as this nation turns around as a result of the things that we have done this day. We want to take this time to pronounce a blessing upon all of us who are here and upon those who are participating in this prayer across the nation and upon this nation. God has given us the responsibility and empowered us as religious leaders to pronounce a blessing. I will ask our Bishop Ndambuki to come and lead us in that prayer. And after that, I'll come back and we'll pronounce a blessing upon the land. Bishop. Archbishop.
Your Excellency, all protocols observed, my fellow Kenyans, I want to take this opportunity to sum up most of the things that we have spoken today before God and before our nation. We have addressed our nation
We entered through a process of repentance. We have examined our hearts before our God. And we have asked ourselves many questions, including of who we are in the presence of God. And now we have come to the end. And I'm concerned because of these things that we've repented and all these things that we are calling God to have mercy upon us. And I reflect Proverbs chapter 6, verse 16. It tells me some of the things that if we are not sincere and we don't come to God with the humble hearts, with the contrite and the broken hearts, to pour ourselves as it was proposed by our president, then we leave gaps and it is all in pain. Let me reflect a bit this verse as we go to pray. There are six things the Lord hates, seven that are detestable to him. Naughty eyes, a lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that devises wicked schemes, feet that are quick to rush into evil, a false witness who pours out lies, and a person who stirs up conflict in the community. We, as a gathering today, have come before the Lord because we know ourselves. We know about our nation. Our nation is hurting. Our nation is ailing. And therefore, we came together as a nation so that we may persuade God to have mercy upon our nation, mercy upon you as an individual. And therefore, at this particular time, because I trust in God, and I trust in all the prayers that were said here before him, and I believe he has heard our prayer. Say many amen. Amen. He has heard our prayers. He has listened to our petition, and it was done, even through music. And now, what is remaining is to humble ourselves so that God may bless us. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we humble ourselves now. After we have listened to the scriptures have spoken to us clearly. They have directed our thoughts. They have inspired our hearts so that we can re-examine ourselves, not leaving anyone behind, because whoever says he has no sin, is that the truth is not in him. And we have come here because we speak the truth. We believe in the truth. We walk in the truth for your glory and honor. Almighty Father, at this particular time, as we humble ourselves to you, we ask you to bless our nation. Inji yetu ambao, wewe mwenyewe uliyumba, ukaiweka mipaka yake, na ukaunganisha makabila yote ya taifa la Kenya. Taifa letu likiwa makabila makubwa na madogo, likiwa na masikini na ikiwa na matajiri. Na wewe mwenyewe ukaijasa utajiri mwingi kwa ajili yetu. Ni sisi tu, we need to be good managers. Ni sisi tu, tunahitaji kuisimamia na kuingawa vilivyo ili uweze kuibariki taifa letu. Naomba mbaraka sitokao kwako, mbaraka uliyemwahidi Ibrahimu. Kamwambia akiwa mtiifu mbele zako na akienda kwa njia zako, utambariki na utabariki na hata uzao wako wake. Na sasa sisi tuko hapa tukingojea kama uzao wa Ibrahimu tuweze kupokea mbaraka kutoka kwako, mbaraka katika mashamba yetu, mbaraka katika mifuko yetu, baraka katika familia zetu, baraka kwa uongozi wa taifa hili kutoka juu mpaka chini, baraka kwa kanisa lote, baraka kwa Waislamu, baraka kwa Wahindu, baraka kwa sisi sote. Na katika hizo baraka zote, he Mungu wetu, tunakuomba utupatie mambo mawili ya muhimu siku ya leo. Ya kwamba kama ishara ya baraka ni peaceful coexistence and the tolerance of our ethnic groups within this land that you secured for us. And again, oh Lord, we want to see our nation united with the proper mind, with the right attitude towards one another, so that our cohesion as a nation that we always cry for may be achieved. For we pray, believing and trusting Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Archbishop. I would like to ask all the religious leaders in the house, those who are here at the front, those who are there at the back, please, if you could stand. We want to pronounce a blessing upon the nation. I want you to raise up your hand, stretch it forth towards Kenyans, those who are here, and those wherever they are. And we want to pray this prayer that is on the screen. So all in unison, let us pray this prayer together over our nation as a blessing. Let's go.
Oh God, our Creator, our Father, we come to you as a nation, asking for your blessings. Pour your blessings, oh God, upon all Kenyans. Teach us how to pursue peace and love in harmony as brothers and sisters. Teach us love and serve one another. Bless those who have suffered calamities, including the COVID illnesses. Bless those who are not in financial difficulties due to COVID. Bless and comfort the bereaved. Heal the sick, comfort the suffering, and uplift the poor. Guide our president, his deputy, and all leaders of our national and county governments. May they use the authority entrusted to them for the peace and prosperity of all Kenyans. May all religious leaders be united and speak boldly in one voice. May we dwell in unity, peace and liberty. May the plenty be found within our borders.
Amen. 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 Amen.
God bless you. God bless you. I'll invite Archbishop to continue from there. Bring
May
it
the peace of God our Father, that surpasses peace that the world gives, be upon our nation and upon you, congregation, now and forevermore.
Amen.
Amen.
We need another round of applause, please, for God. A loud applause. A louder one. For God. A second round for our nation. And for our citizens, a final round of applause. Normally at this juncture, ladies and gentlemen, we normally invite one another to shake hands, to show warmth. If I did that, it would be totally wrong. But surely, by turning your head to your neighbor, you can tell him or her, may God be with you. May God bless you. May God use you. Namaste. Namaste. Peace. Peace. My dear sisters and brothers, we have walked today a path of prayer, a path of seeking God's mercy, a path of listening, and hopefully a path of conversion. Our country needs conversion for many reasons for which we've prayed. But above all, my dear sisters and brothers, dear Kenyans, we all still need to take seriously this battle against COVID-19. We have won a first stage of battle. Woe on us if we were to lose a second one. It is important that big and small, high and low, village and town dwellers take seriously what we have really been asked to be our sisters and brothers keeper. We cannot pray for God's blessings as to present dangers to my sister and my brother and my father and my mother and my grandfather and my grandmother. As religious leaders, I stand here on their behalf to plead, to ask humbly that all of us, our dear leaders, and all of us, religious leaders, and all of us, wherever we are, citizens, Kenyans, whatever you do and wherever you are, please listen to the voice of the Lord. Be your sister's keeper. Be your brother's keeper. Don't let down that God has helped us. The graces we've received are many. Let them not fall to the ground. Wear your mask. Wear your mask. Wear your mask. Follow the indications. The Ministry of Health kindly is a godly call to keep and be your sister's and brother's keeper. May God bless us. At this moment, we have come to the end. That was almost like a commercial break. But surely, it is more than a commercial break. It is a godly break. I'm sure would wish all of us to thank our media who have been so kind to air today's program and to invite every Kenyan, wherever they will meet in this weekend in the place of worship, and those who met yesterday and will meet next Friday, please let us pray with an open heart for God's blessings, for our nation, for our leadership, and especially so that we may face the big dragons, the big threats that are facing us of COVID and other social ills. Today there are no speeches. I only present this as a petition and on behalf of my sisters and brothers, the whole entire nation of religious leaders, we kindly insist, listen to the voice of God. Peace, peace, peace. At this moment, we want to thank our president who actually asked us to organize this particular prayer day. He was also kind enough to declare the 3 days of prayer. Surely we are in your house, Your Excellency, and I'm sure you'd want to at least say something as a host to say thank you that we have come, because maybe you'd have been alone, or at least to say yes, your desires have been met. It is really a kind request, because we are in your house, we cannot leave without you saying a word to encourage us. So please, with all due reverence and respect, maybe not following the right protocols, but kindly, Your Excellency, say a word to us.
Please be seated. Thank you very much. I thought we had a deal, Your Grace, that the function was going to end with prayers, that there were no speeches. But all the same, I just want to take this opportunity. This is not my day. This is a day that we have agreed to dedicate our nation to God. And so As I start my thanks, let me first and foremost thank the Almighty God for keeping us safe and for helping us reach where we are today. Because for sure, we would not have been able to do that without his guidance, without his love. And we need to recognize that. And indeed, as has been said, we have undergone very serious challenges. And again, as has been cited, we may have won a number of battles, but the war is yet to be won. And we need to continue to ask our Creator to stand with us even as we move forward from today. So today is our day of thanksgiving. It's our day of repentance. It's our day also of continuing to seek God's favor on this land and her people. I think the second thing I would like to do is to thank all our religious leaders from the various religious organizations in Kenya, from our churches to the mosques to the temples, who have set aside this day and have come to lead not just this congregation, but the entire nation in prayer today. Asante ni sana, tumewashukuru sana. Thank you. Thank you very much. We deeply, deeply appreciate the role that you have played. I think it would also be wrong for me if I also didn't take this opportunity to thank all our health workers, all our essential service providers who have gone above and beyond the call of duty during this most difficult time. And I think on behalf of a grateful nation, tunasema asanteni sana. I would also be wrong if I did not also thank my fellow leaders, all those of us who have been in cabinet together, all our county governments, including all our leaders in various political parties. If it was not for the unity of purpose that you have shown during this time, we would not have been able to come so far. Asanteni sana. Thank you very much to each and every one of you. Tunasema asante. Ya mwisho, tumeambiwa tuseme ya kwamba tukimshukuru Mungu na tuseme ya kwamba dhambi zetu atusamehe na tusameheane, si ni kweli? Kwa hivyo mimi naomba wote, kama kuna mtu mimi nimefanyia makosa, naomba msamaha. Na kama kuna moja wenu ambaye amenikosea mimi nimemsamehe. Hiyo ndio njia pekee ya kusonga na kuendelea mbele. Amani, tumeambiwa amani. Amani, amani ya kudumu, na wananchi waishi pamoja. Mungu na wabariki, Mungu na walinde, na tuendelee kupeleka taifa letu mbele. Asanteni sana.
May I request all of us to be upstanding as the choir will lead us into the Kenya National Anthem. That's